The first video in How to Learn Scratch is the starter. We'll learn the basics and then we'll take a tour of Scratch. There's even a bonus first program. Let's start with the basics. This is what you first see when you open Scratch. It might seem a little bit confusing, but after a short while you'll be able to use it quite easily. We're going to write little programs, and you do that by using these blocks. You can see the middle, we have these blue blocks, and if we move the blocks onto this big area, this area called the script area, we can see this block says move 10 steps. If I click this block, you can see the cat will move. I'm going to change the steps to 50 steps and then click on the block, and you can see the cat move. Over here, this cat, like this object, called a sprite. And if I click the block, that makes the sprite do the action that the block says. I'm just going to make this block bigger. And you can see it says move 50 steps. If I right click on it, you can see I can duplicate it, or delete it, or even add a comment. So if I want to duplicate it, you can see I have two blocks, and if I put them together, when I click, it will do both. I can move the cat back, and you can see that the cat moves 50 steps twice. You'll see that the blocks are all blue here, and there's quite a lot of X and Y. I'll explain them a bit later. But the reason why they're blue is they're to do with motion, moving. And you can see above here, there are different colours for different types of actions. So for example, the next one is events. The top one, it says when the green flag is clicked. And what that means is that when you want to start a program, you can click on the green flag to start it. And next to it, there's like a red circle, and then you click on that to stop the program. If we look at some other blocks, we have these purple blocks. We can say hello for 2 seconds. We click, and you can see it says hello for 2 seconds. Notice that I click the block onto the previous block. If I don't, then it won't do the action. If I move the block back, that's the equivalent of deleting it. So I move the block over and snap to the previous block. I can start the program. You can see the cat moves and says hello. We're not going to go through all of the blocks here, but you can see I can move the block over. There are blocks for sound, for example. So here we've got play sound meow. You have different blocks and the colours showing. This one's for drawing in green, a lighter green for some maths, and even some programming variable and a list. Go back to motion, we can see if we keep moving the cat, it will disappear. So we want things like if on edge bounce. So when we run that, we can see once the cat reaches the edge, it stays on the screen. You can see there that the cat turned upside down. If you don't want that, there's a block to stop it happening. So here we've got this set rotation style, and we have this drop down list. So you can look in here for don't rotate, all around, or left and right. So these blocks you'll get used to using, and you can write little programs by using the blocks, move them onto this script area, and then running the program. It's useful to know where things are in Scratch, so let's have a little tour. We've looked at the blocks, and we can see we have the different colours, different blocks. A That's all in the scripts area. Next to that we have costumes. You can see here that the cat has another costume. Next to that is sound. We can go back to the script area. Above these we have these little pictures. Here it says shrink. If we click on that and move over to the cat, we can make it smaller. Next to this we have grow, so we can make it bigger. We have a pair of scissors. It says delete. If we delete that, oh dear, we've deleted everything that we've done, so that's not good. Here's a tip. We could go to edit and undelete, so that brings everything back. So we have this menu here as well. The last little picture says duplicate. If you put the mouse cursor over the picture, you can see what it says. So that says duplicate. If I try that, put it onto the cat. You see here, there's two cats. This is the sprite area. So we had our cat, which we created our code with, and this is now a copy. You could see there's a little eye in the corner. If we click on the eye, we have some information. So you could change the name of the cat here. If we right click, we can duplicate, and also we can delete. So maybe we don't want two cats. Next to the sprite area, you can see this box here. This is the backdrop, which is the background. So we can click on this. You can see these four little pictures here. We've got a picture of a camera. We've got a picture of a file. We've got a picture for drawing. And we've also got a picture here. It says choose backdrop from library. So this means that we can choose a different background. So for example, we have stars. Click OK. And you can see now that the background of our area is stars. If you want to make the picture of the whole screen, you can see this box, this rectangle here. And that makes the picture look the whole screen. So here we have a view using the whole screen. We can run our program using the green flag, remember? And if we go back to the rectangle, the box, we can go back to our normal view. Although we're on backdrop, if we go back to scripts, it looks empty. It's because we've got the backdrop selected. So you can actually put boxes, a code, into the backdrop. So we want to click on our sprite to see our blocks that we created before. Okay, so remember that if your blocks seem to disappear, then maybe you've selected the backdrop or a different object, a different sprite. So here's our sprite with our stars behind it. Now if you want to save your program, we can go up to here. We have file, we can save as, and then give your file a name. I'm going to call this program 1 and then save, and that's saved. You also have things like tips, so here's some tips. About will take you to the web page. You've seen edit. Turbo mode to make it go faster. We can go back to that to turn it off. And that's our short tour of Scratch. To move the cat around the screen, we can use X and Y. If we want to move the cat forward, we can use X. So here we've got our block. We start at 0, 0. The middle is 0, 0. If we change x to a high number, 100, you can see it moves forward. If we change it to a low number, like minus 100, you'll see it goes backwards. We go back to 0, 0, we're in the middle. Now y, we can go up and down. If we go to y equals 100, we can see it goes up. If we have y equals minus 100, you can see it go down. And if both x and y are minus, it'll go into the bottom left hand corner. So that's how we use x and y. You can see we can change the values here.
A few things.
Let's put x
first program.
Y back at 0, the cat's in the middle.
So
you can see the x and y values when you move the cursor around.
And here we can choose different characters. We're going to choose Avery walking. Click on the picture and then we go down to click on OK. So that puts the lady in our picture and we can right click and delete the cat. We can look at her costumes and you'll see she has four costumes, which means these are different pictures of her walking. Now we want to see her walking. So we're going to choose move 10 steps. We can change that to 100 steps and now click. So we click on the block and she moves 100 steps. Now we can add if on edge bounce block, and also if we go to control we can add a forever block around their two blue motion blocks. We try that and you can see she's going a bit too fast. We can go in events and add the green flag when green flag clicked. Try that. And when we click the red circle, that will stop. We want to slow her down a bit, so we go in control and wait 1 second. Now she's going a bit too slow. So what we can do is change the 1 second down, maybe 0.1 seconds. Let's try that. Maybe a bit too fast. What do you think? You can see the four costumes she's changing one. At the moment, she's not changing the costumes. So we need to go to the looks and next costume to change from one costume to the next. So this will go from 1, 2, 3, 4 back to 1. So now she's actually walking. Stop that, and we can change it so she's walking a bit slower. So let's try 0.2 seconds. Click the green flag. You can see that's okay. We can stop that, move her back to the middle and try that. That looks okay. She's walking and it's not too fast or too slow. If we want to use more than one character, we can right click and then move the character. You can see if we just select it, right click and select duplicate, and now we have exactly the same sprite. Yeah, maybe we don't want all of them, we can just right click and delete, but you can see that made a copy. What we actually want, we want a different character. So we select the bat and then OK and we move that up. We can see here we have all of the code that we want, and we want it for the bat, so we can drag the code over to the bat, and now the bat sprite has the same code. The blocks we had for Avery, we've now moved to the bat by dragging them. So we can run that and you can see that the girl walks and the bat flies. You could look at the costume of the bat and it has two, one where its wings are up and one where its wings are down. So what we did there, we created a new sprite and then we dragged the code, the blocks, over from the girl over to the bat, the picture in the sprites. We click on the shrink button and then on the bat to make it smaller, and then we're going to change to 0.1 to make the bat go faster. There's a lot more we can do in Scratch. You could see there's many other blocks that we could use. For example, we could add sound, so we can play sound effect or music. We have looks with the costume. We have motion, and we have these other blocks that we can use to add to our program. Have sensing, so if something's touching a color or another object, and we can make the picture bigger, so when we run our program we can see our program. Let's move them before we do that, and then we press the green flag and then we can see our program running. Press the red circle to stop that and go back, so we can see our program running there. We have our code in the character, in the person, in the bat. Now you might want to change the background, the backdrop, so you can look in the library. These are backdrops in the library that we can use. So you can just select one of them, just click on one of the backgrounds and then click OK, and then when you run the program you can see that the program runs with that background that you've chosen. So you can see the different parts, the scripts and the costumes, once we select either the background, the person walking, or the bat flying. So you click on the object or the background to see the code of that character. Well, that brings us to the end of our starter. I hope you enjoyed it. Please give us a like if you did. And if there's anything missing, is there anything that you want to know, please let us know in a comment and we'll reply. Thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. See you for the next video. Bye for now.